feel your group has gained a lot of confidence? So, I mean, before the season, the offensive line was kind of a big question. Everyone was saying they're a question mark, and they're not saying that right now. They're looking at other places. Do you feel your position group is kind of...
I think we've always, as an offensive line, had confidence in ourselves. That started back in the winter, back when we started figuring out kind of meshing together. I mean, we go out every week before the game as a unit. We do everything. I mean, we're a really close unit, and I think that has pushed us and bonded us together to be that stronghold. And I mean, we always want to say, put it on us, and that's just kind of the mentality that us as an offensive line have come to be.
Do you especially say that in a game where, I mean, Taylor was throwing the ball, he made some mistakes, is now a time when you especially say, put it on us? Let's, you know,
I think that's where we're going to be. I mean, that's where we want to be as an offensive line. I mean, that's the best offensive line in the country are the ones that can do that, the ones that can sit there and say, coach, put it on us, let's run the ball, we'll do it. I mean, who cares if they're putting 18 guys in the box, let's still run the ball type of thing. And that's the mentality that us as an offensive line are working towards.
Were you a little surprised, disappointed that there were 14 passes called there, about 15 plays?
No, I mean, that's Coach Beck. I mean, I have all confidence in Coach Beck. I mean, he saw something that he thought we could exploit through the passing game. And, I mean, from what I've seen, I've heard that there was some things that here, one or two things, like I said, something was missed by a receiver, or missed by the quarterback, or a missed block by the offensive line, just one little thing that could have led to a big play that could have turned everything around.
How did you guys, maybe over the last 36 hours, just sort of bounce back, circle the wagons, you know, every cliche?
Yeah, I think that we've just bonded together as a team. I mean, we're going to stick together through this. I mean, we got to make sure that some guys are going to have rougher patches than others. I mean, some guys are going to want to kind of sulk, and we can't do that. I mean, it's not like we have, all right, it's a couple weeks before we play again. I mean, we play a game in 6 days type of thing. I mean, there's no time to sit around and, oh, well, we'll get it fixed eventually. It's no, we got to get it fixed now. We got to go out to practice field today and start preparing for Ohio State. What's done is done. As much as we'd love to be able to get back and redo it, we're not going to be able to, and we just need to make sure that we're prepared when it comes to kickoff next Saturday.
Ohio State defense, I mean, they have a reputation over the years of being really good against the run. What, if anything, do you know about them?
Haven't really started a lot of film study. Got started on it yesterday for a little bit, but I haven't gone done. I mean, like you said, it's Ohio State. They've always had a great defense. Up front seven, they take their pride on, and I think it's going to be a really good matchup for us to see where we are as a running football team. Where we are as a rushing team, I mean, if we can get the ball to Rex and Taylor and Amir and Aaron out on the edges, and you can keep the edge option game along with the inside run game, I think we can have a good balance against these guys.
Wisconsin chose to drop the coverage a little bit and just contain Taylor. Was that the nature of the game when they got up 7 or 14, or was that something you'd seen other teams trying to do with you guys?
It reminded me a little bit of like Texas last year. I think Texas did a little bit of it too. But, I mean, I don't think there's much containing Taylor's. They were just rushing. I think the O-line did a pretty good job of picking up the protection-wise. I think we did a pretty good job, and we prepared during the week looking at the different looks that they were going to give us with putting different guys around. I mean, the third nickel downs when they had 5-6 guys kind of standing up milling around. And so I think we picked it up pretty good. But I don't know. I study coverage some, but I mean, I couldn't tell you if they're dropping back into cover two or cover four. I'm more worried about who's coming in the A gap and the B gap.
They didn't blitz you much, though. I mean,
they didn't blitz much, but we knew that coming in. I mean, Wisconsin wasn't a big blitz team all around. Like I said in last week's, they're very fundamentally sound. They're just kind of good at what they do, and they did a pretty good job with that, I thought.
You guys still hang your hat on the fact that there's still so much out there for you. I mean, one loss is going to kill you in this situation.
Exactly. I mean, everything, I mean, even the national championship's still out there for us. I mean, one loss teams have done it before. I mean, if we can run the table here, which is what we're planning to do, go back to the Big Ten championship, go to the Big Ten championship and get another shot at maybe Wisconsin, whoever wins that other division. I mean, the Big Ten championship's out there for us. Another going, running out the rest of the table, so out there for us. I mean, there's a lot of football out there. I mean, there's 7 games left to play. We're not even at the halfway point of the season yet, so we still got a lot of football left to play, and we still got a long ways to go as a team, but we can definitely get there.
Yeah.